Welcome to all the students. The course of Industrial Management, for which the subject code is RAS601, and the topic for the presentation is Unit 4, Quality Control, and SQC, Statistical. The content which I'm going to deliver throughout the presentation is Introduction to Quality, Quality Control as well as Quality Assurance, Quality Management, the various phases through which the quality evolves, that is development phases, variation or defect and their causes, and methods to control the quality. Start with the presentation with the definition of quality, but before proceeding to the definition, first we'll discuss the need of quality. What is the need of quality? Why quality is needed? While you go to the market to purchase any of the good or service, what are the traits or features you are looking for in the product? We are looking for good functionality, efficiency, effectiveness, warranty or guarantee associated with the products, and after sale services. These are nothing but traits which differentiate a qualitative product with the local one. In case of local product, all these traits are absent. That is, it is not associated with the quality, it is not associated with the warranty, guarantee, after sale services. Yes, one of the factors which makes different with the qualitative product to the local product is cost. Obviously, the cost of local product is quite low because of the absence of these traits in it. And that is why we believe in the products like BIS hallmark, ISI hallmark, because these hallmarks product provides a kind of assurance to the consumer towards the quality of the product. One of the other aspect of quality is the conformance of requirement. I'm going to take an example to explain the conformance of requirement by using the gear, example of gear. Gears are used to operate the wristwatch, as well as they are used to extract the juice in the sugar factory from the sugar cane. In both these places, in both these machineries, gears made up of different material, different size, different purposes, but we cannot conclude that the gear used in wristwatch is good as compared to the gear used in sugar cane industry. They both are meant for different purposes and they fulfill their own purpose, intended purpose. So they both the gears used for their intended purpose, and so they both are said to be a qualitative product. There are various, they provide their quality definition. Some of the definitions are stated on the slide. That is, as per the Oxford Dictionary, quality is a degree of excellence. As per Defoe and Juran, quality is nothing but the fitness for purpose. If the product is fit for the purpose, that is intended purpose for which the product is designed, the quality, the product is said to be qualitative. Another definition is quoted and written at here by Crosby. He defined quality as the conformance of requirement. If the product is conform the requirement made by the user, then the product is qualitative. Another definition provided by American Statistical and Quality Control Cell, that is the totality of features and characteristics of the product and services that bear on its ability to satisfy the given needs. Obviously, when as a consumer I go to the market, then I purchase the good only and only when the utility derived from the product will be greater than or equal to the price paid for that. Otherwise, I will not purchase the product. And also, the product quality is measured in terms of after sales support. If after sales services are good and warranty as well as guarantee are associated with the product, that also means a lot. Further, in this slide, number of characteristics or dimensions are stated, which can be categorized into two ways. One is the quantitative characteristic, another is qualitative aspect of the quality. Quantity, when we talk about quantitative aspect of quality, the features which can be measurable, they comes under the category of countable or quantitative features of quality, that is like structural characteristics, time-oriented characteristics, structural characteristics like weight of a cane, strength of a particular beam, viscosity of a fluid. Time-oriented characteristics, they are also measurable. Warranty of 2 years, reliability in terms of say 0.9, maintainability, all these are measurable terms. That is why these characteristics are known as quantitative aspect of quality. Whereas some of the traits are of qualitative type, like sensory characteristics, including taste of the food, smell of the perfume, beauty of the model, honesty of a person, courtesy, friendliness nature of a particular product, particular person. All these are ethical characteristics. So sensory as well as ethical characteristics lies in the category of qualitative aspects of quality, qualitative traits of quality. Now, further, we'll discuss the terms related to the quality, that is quality assurance as well as quality control. Quality assurance may be defined as all the actions and terms and efforts made by the manufacturer or service provider which assure, which provide a kind of assurance to the consumer about the quality of the product. It is a proactive approach and starts from quality planning, system improvement such as defect prevention, improving reliability of the product, and maintaining the quality at each and every step. Whereas quality control is a term which is primarily related to identifies and respond to the non-conformity or defects in the process, and it is corrective approach. Another term, that is quality management. Quality management is the term which is related to manage. Manage means to plan, organizing, directing, coordinating, controlling the quality and quality related issues at each and every level in the organization, so that the overall quality of the product can be ensured. Ahead to the development phases of the quality. Quality word was coined in the early 19th century. Before that, production concept was in use, and as per that, when the market was oligopolistic, when the market was not oligopolistic, monopolistic, that is where number of players were low, then obviously people have no choice to purchase the product produced by the manufacturer. But with the increase pace of industrialization, the manufacturer tries to improve the quality of the product. Just because with the increase in number of players in the market, people have choice. When people have choice, then they will purchase the product from either from seller A or from B. So in that case, in order to capture more and more market share, more and more sales volume, the manufacturer or service provider concern towards the quality of the product. And so In the beginning of 19th century, the quality and evolution of quality takes place. In the very first phase, operators was responsible to maintain the quality within the product, and that is why this phase is known as operators quality control phase or craftsman quality control phase. Later on, with the increase in production volume, the quality inspectors were appointed on the production floor so as to control the quality of the product at the processing stage. The work of those quality inspector is to ensure that the product should be non-defective, that is, there should be no variability within the process. But the quality inspectors works on the basis of experience and observations. There were no statistical means were available with them. But later on, during the World War II, when statistical means are being introduced or developed by the scholars, then statistical quality control phase comes into existence, in which number of statistical tools like scatter chart, bar chart, pie chart, histogram are used to analyze the data and to analyze the variation in the observation. Later on, it was realized by the management of the company that quality is not a function of the quality inspector only. Quality is the responsibility of each and every employee work in an organization. So the new word comes into the existence, that is total quality control, in which the cross-functional teams was formed who were responsible to maintain the quality within the product at each and every level. But the approach was take the corrective action. The approach was not the proactive one. And later on, Japanese find out this drawback of the total quality control phase. This concept was renewed by them, and they introduce quality as total quality management. They introduce the management, and the role of management was increased so as to plan, organize, directing, coordinating and controlling quality right from the inception to the end consumer. Now when we talk about quality control, what we are talking about? We are controlling the defect, the variation within the process. So any type of non-conformity that is arises within the product or services during processing or after processing is known as defect. These defects may arise in the process due to either by chance or due to some assignable causes. By chance, if the variation arises in the process, then it cannot be controlled. Yes, it can be controlled up to a certain extent only. Like vibration arises on the machine, the fluctuation in the power takes place, due to which the variation occurs within the result, or variation arises in the composition of material due to which the defect may arise. These causes are randomly arise and their frequency is very low, whereas some of the causes are assignable, like lack of skill of operator, wrong maintenance practices, error in setting the Zixson fixture, raw material defects. They can be noted, and the suitable action can be taken in order to remove the problem. And to remove the problem related to the variation in an organization related to quality of the product, the organization should follow a series of steps that starts from formulating an appropriate quality policy first. Then for that, organization have to set the standards or specifications. Later on, they have to select the proper inspection plan and set up the procedure for checkout. And they have to check out the process in order to find out the variation. After getting the variations against the set standards of specification, management should take the corrective actions or necessary changes to achieve the standards. They also have to develop the salvage method for both type of defect, temporary as well as permanent. For temporary defect, if the temporary defect arises, then by reworking their product can be reused. But the permanent defect arises in the product, then the product will be in scrap. However, coordination as well as direction are required at each and every stage to resolve the quality problems, and coordination arises with the consciousness, with developing the quality consciousness both within and outside the organization. Apart from that, the development of good vendor-vendee relation also helps to maintain the quality within the organization. Next comes the methods of quality control. There are a number of methods to control the quality on the shop floor. Some of the methods are offline quality control methods, statistical process control method, and acceptance sampling plans. These are the methods are in your syllabus, and we'll focus on specially statistical process control as well as acceptance sampling. Offline quality control method is the method in which the quality inspector was appointed to check the quality and monitor the quality at each and every stage by either observing by their own experience, past experience. Whereas statistical process control is a technique in which statistical tools are used in order to find out the variation within. Next comes the statistical quality control. In detail, we'll study about the statistical quality control and various tools. Statistical quality control is nothing but the use and application of statistical techniques by the organizations or professionals to assess the variation within the process and to appraise that in future the variation should not be occur. The approach is focused on prevention of defect rather than detection and correction. This approach is very useful in planning for improvement in the product. As far as concerned with this SQC method, as the name suggests itself, the quality control method is based on the statistical data. This data may be of two types, variable type as well as attribute type. Variable type data are is the data that can be measured along a continuous scale and by using say length, weight, in terms of force, etc. Whereas attributable type data is having the characteristics that are countable or categorized into discrete classes, and we can find out the variation in terms of percentage defective as well as defective per unit by using. Before proceeding the statistical control chart, statistical process control, the terms, basic terms one should be revised or know, that are measure of central tendency as well as measure of variation. All these things you have studied earlier in mathematics also. Measure of central tendency is nothing but, as the name suggests itself, we have to measure the central or the mean value of the data. Say for example, if the manufacturer producing 1000 workpiece having the diameter D, then out of those 1000, if the tolerance limit, the limit up to which the product is acceptable, is plus minus say 0.5 mm, then we can easily find out the central position of the data, that is D. It can be found out by taking mean, mod, median, Whereas dispersal in the data can be seen or observed by using range standard deviation. Mean can be calculated by taking the average, arithmetic average of the entire population or by the sample chosen out of population. Mean is represented by the symbol mu, and for the entire population capital N, it can be calculated by using the formula sigma xi divided by n. Whereas for if the samples are selected from the entire population, then it can be calculated by using the formula x bar is equal to summation of xi divided by n. Similarly, median is nothing but the middle observation in the group of data ordered by magnitude. The data are ordered in either ascending order or descending order, and the median is the halfway through the ordered list. If there are even number of observations are there in the observation table, then the median can be calculated by taking the average of the two in the middle of the ordered list. Mod. Mod is nothing but the value that occurs frequently in the observation. Measure of variation, as I told you earlier, provides the how much the data is spread or how much the data is dispersed from its mean value. So from mean value, the minimum or maximum value, by getting those two value, by taking the difference, we can calculate the range within which the product is specified. If the product goes out of this limit, tolerance limit plus minus, then we can say the process is out of control for that particular object or observation. Variance is nothing but the variability in the data, and for entire population capital N, it can be calculated by using the formula sigma square is equal to summation of xi minus mu whole square divided by n. And for the sample size small s, it can be calculated by summation of sigma sr xi minus x bar whole square divided by small. Another useful term that is standard deviation, also helpful to find out the variation in the data. It can be calculated by taking the root mean square of the variance and represented by symbol sigma. Sigma is equals to under root summation of x square minus n times mu square divided by n for the entire population. Whereas if we have sample out of total population n, then we can calculate it by using formula s is equals to under root summation of xi minus x bar small n minus 1. If we plot all these variation as well as central tendency on a particular plot, then through normal distribution we can find out the mean value, the control limit for the process, as well as variation around the mean value. Here the normal distribution curve is representing the mean value and variation around the mean value. The normal distribution can be calculated, can be represented by symbol z, and can be calculated by the formula z is equals to x minus mu divided by sigma. If the mean of the process as well as standard deviation is known, then we can find out the normal standard normal distribution. This distribution is based on a theorem that is known as central limit theorem, which states that the distribution of the sample mean from an infinite population will approach a normal distribution as the sample size increases. Further proceeding, there are various statistical tools and techniques which are used to collect, analyze, and find out the variation in the data. These techniques are mainly graph or flow chart, check sheets, histogram or bar charts, Pareto chart, cause and effect diagram, scatter chart, and process chart or control chart. Out of these techniques, check sheets are used to collect the data. Process flow chart are used to show the flow of process in a sequence manner. Histogram or bar chart are used to compare the data. Pareto chart are based on the assumption that 90% of the defects are arises due to 10% causes. And if 10% causes are handled properly, then 90% defect will be reduced in the process. Another diagram useful to find out the variation in the process is cause and effect diagram that was developed by Ishikawa, and so is known as Ishikawa diagram or fishboat diagram also, because it is having the shape of fish. And so on the bow side, the effects are mentioned, whereas the lateral side, the causes are mentioned in terms of resources. Another diagram that is of great importance is scatter diagram, which shows the dispersal of data from its mean value. And last but not least, control or process chart. These are the key indicator or important tool to find out the variability within the process. In the next lecture, we'll discuss control charts and their types in detail.